Yo, 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 what up, motherfuckers? Blah. My name is Wendy's Frosty.
Drunk.
I just made that up. Hope that was entertaining.
Hmm.
Bet everyone thought I was going to eat them more, but I'm just going to eat this Frosty.
It's so cold. Oh, shit. More red plants. I don't have any. Oh shit, I don't have any of those either. I don't have any life potions.
You know what you need right now?
Damn it, I needed all those. Motherfucker. I have no life because I fought these two crazy big ass, like, things and I didn't record it. And it was hard as hell and I pretty much used all my health.
Why did you record it?
Because it was really late and I was just trying to, like, kill time and get some, like, items and shit. Ended up, like, fucking going crazy, like, with the kills. It was, like, just crazy. It was those two, like, guys that dig under the ground, they're so fucking hard to kill. Like, their weakness, I, like, put down, like, pretty much, I put down 24 traps, and they hit them all, and it still didn't kill them. It was crazy. I'm like, why aren't they dying? I don't understand.
Save these for the trail.
Sorry, it's a bit boring, but I need help. I need health. Care.
Sunfall. Ooh. The Mad King Drowned Summer Palace. A bulwark of Karja might against the howling Forbidden West.
Thanks for the history lesson.
But they have no idea what lies beneath. We will learn much from this, Aloy.
That's what I'm hoping.
They look like red
ones.
I
need that.
But they're not red, they're orange. Looks like I gotta go right there. Are those bad guys?
Saving these for the trail.
There you go.
I thought of Uthid. She's very pale. Is she unwell?
Yes. She's a fighter, but the fever on her won't lift. It only burns hotter. Her name is Shiana, my sister.
Isn't there anyone in Sunfall who can help?
We're refugees. We know our place. And there's only one healer in the territory. He's difficult. His soul is in shadow.
His soul is in shadow.
Galiv. That's him. He's very clever,
but
he has little care for people. Perhaps the desert scoured it all away. Perhaps he was always like that. Either way, I know he won't help us.
Well, I'll see about that. Where would I find him?
Last I heard, he was patching up soldiers at Blazon Arch. Another border battle.
I never would have thought Beefy capable of abandoning us like this.
Come take a look.
Some stuff.
Don't pass up these goods.
Cutscene. Whoa. It's like a gladiator. What is that?
The Sunbreak.
Nothing, there's just some crazy, like, gladiator thing happening. Like, there's like a... what is it called? Like a pit where they fight, I guess, machines.
Now we get to see if your attack on their focus network was entirely successful.
What are you talking about? Did I crash the network or not?
Success. Welcome to the Citadel, Aloy. I'll check back with you in a moment.
That was weird. It was like a weird cut.
Circulate.
Guess nobody is immune to the temptation of heresy. Not even Uther.
Outlanders, if you want to hear about today's bounties, head for the throne room. You're not going to make any shards by standing out here. Filthy mercenaries.
After this ceasefire, perhaps
I'll take the shards, even if it means having to listen to Bahamas.
I hear the Shadow Conjurer are looking for one of their own. Should pay well.
So apparently one of the power cells is like at the end or... of like one of the missions of like a later part.
All he said was gone.
By the glory of the sun revealed.
Why don't you take your coat off, you're cold.
Behold, radiant Edomon, the one true Sun King, the light in shadow, whose will is light and whose light is law.
I command Lucian Bahavas to speak in my behalf.
By the will of Radiant Edomon does the sun glare down mercilessly upon the traitor Uthid. to the hunter who brings his head to us shall go a bounty of 500 shards.
More prisoners than royalty, don't you think? Love your hair. You and I need to chat, little huntress. The green tent down in Shadowside. I'll be waiting.
Kind of busy.
We both know you're no killer for hire. Ufid is innocent. So come see me while there's still time to save him.
So, the way in I spoke of is right behind you.
You've got to be kidding.
Not at all. And you needn't worry about the Kestrels. They'll be too busy acting important to pay attention to you.
First time in the Citadel, gotta see the sun ring from on high.
Well, the Kestrels.
Ah, they want us to see this, boy. It makes quite an impression.
It's the sun drawing the faithful out.
This is insane.
The balustrade. It's a short drop from there.
Oh, shit.
My.
I gotta climb. Okay. Mm-hmm. Are you tired, babe? You sound
I'm
tired.
Getting tired, yeah.
You can go to sleep if you want to. Watch it later. Oh, shit!
You can make it down. Piece for piece.
No, I have to go across. I'm not supposed to be down here. Shit. I'm supposed to be jumping across. Okay, back to where that was. I'm not gonna play long anyway, because like I said, I gotta wake up. See, I gotta like run across that or some shit. Climb down. I don't know how I'm supposed to do this. No. Okay. Well, whatever. I thought that part was like a able to climb.
What the? Is that a tall neck?
No, it's a behemoth.
Jeez.
Like I was supposed to make it this way, but I don't know how. Oh well, it just says climb down.
The other side of the tower. Look for a vent.
I see you've been here before.
Obviously. Now, it's very important that you hear what I'm about to say. I've shown you the way in, but this humble vent marks a point of no return. Before you descend into the depths here, you should be fully committed, equipped, and focused. No distractions. If you have errands to run, do them first or hold your peace. I won't tolerate whining. Is that clear?
You ready for this shit?
I don't have any health.
Better be ready. This is going down.
I have these.
So they got, you know what this is, right? The descent into the hole.
Tolerate what I give you, Silence. I didn't ask you along for the ride.
No, I need to get my fucking... I gotta get, it's annoying, but I gotta get, like, something for health, because if I fight, I'm just gonna die, because I don't have anything. Where's that sales guy?
I'm glad you're on our side.
Okay, cool. Now that I have help. Tired, I could hear it. Why don't you go lay down then?
I probably will.
Because, like I said, I'm not gonna play long. I'll do this and then I'll. Because I gotta wake up early, so I'm not trying to.
I'll come back later.
Alrighty, babies.
That woman said to me about a green tent.
I'll see you later.
Okay, see you.
Oi.
I'm heading down.
I've spent a lifetime trying to uncover the secrets of this world. Where the machines came from. How the old ones achieved such marvels only to fall into silence and death. A lifetime of failure. As year by year, decade after decade, I hit walls I could not break, doors I could never breach.
Hello.
Until Honora Huntress marched out of the savage east. And voila, for her, all the deepest secrets of the earth were laid bare. I suspect you will have an easier time with this door than I did years ago.
Hold for identiscan. Genetic profile confirmed. Entry authorized. Malfunction. 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 Malfunction.
Are you kidding me?
You don't hear me laughing.
Shut up. There's gotta be another way. Hey! Elizabeth Sobeck here! Requesting access!
Access request acknowledged. Root command functions available. Do you wish to proceed?
I do! Get me through this door!
Analyzing. Primary access inoperable due to mechanical failure. Emergency venting procedure likely to circumvent blockage. Do you wish to proceed?
Yes.
Emergency venting authorized.
Everything.
That will draw attention. We won't have this place to ourselves for long now.
We? Last I checked, I was the one risking my life down here.
Yes, fine. Now will you please get moving? There's so much to learn in less time than I'd hoped.
Here we go.
Welcome to Project Zero Dawn.
Zero Dawn. We found it.
Are you really so surprised?
Facility diagnostics detect multiple failures. Attempting repair.
So, what was this room?
An entrance hall, perhaps. Have a look around.
Please take a seat and wait for your name. A selection of beverages and snacks are available.
A smaller room.
There's oh, what you call it? Parasol, I think, in this section. because I can't miss it, because you get some crazy armor. No, this isn't it. It ain't here.
Please proceed into viewing room one for an important message regarding the purpose of your visit.
Holographic theater.
CD unwound data intact. Initiating playback.
Welcome to Project Zero Dawn. I am General Harris, Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff of the United States of America. I'm sure you've heard the rumors that Zero Dawn is a top secret super weapons program, the technological miracle that will save us from the Pharaoh Plague. If Operation Enduring Victory can hold off the robots long enough. The reason I'm sure you've heard the rumors is that I'm the one who spread them. And they are all lies. Zero Dawn is not a super weapons program. And it will not save us. Nothing will save us. Here's why. By the time the glitch was noticed, it was already too late. Nothing could stop the Pharaoh Plague. Nothing can. Its robots will continue to replicate and devour the biosphere. Life on Earth will be destroyed. Our planet reduced to a barren sphere. Global extinction is inevitable. No matter how many we kill, the robots just keep exponentially making more. If we had their deactivation codes, we could shut them all down. The entire swarm. But since their cryptographic protocols use polyphasic entangled waveforms, cracking a code set would take half a century. At best, we've got 16 months. Not exactly what you'd call a survival option. The destruction of a biosphere is not the sort of apocalypse you can wait out in a fallout shelter or a space station. There will be no Earth left to reclaim. Just a lifeless, toxic rock with several million Pharaoh robots on it, hibernating. Waiting for something to eat. This is the horrible truth behind the lies of Operation Enduring Victory. My lies. Lies designed to inspire millions of innocents to sacrifice themselves in battle. Why? One reason. To buy time for you and the work you will do here. Zero Day. The day that life on Earth ceases to exist. Is coming fast. It cannot be stopped. The hope of Zero Dawn is that something new might come after. But I will leave it to Elizabeth Sobeck to shine that thin ray of light into the darkness. Harris, out.
I don't know about this.
Life on Earth didn't cease to exist.
He said it could not be stopped.
But it was. Somehow Elizabeth saved us. I've got to keep looking. Find out how she did it. Kestrels. They got in. Through the vents.
Let nothing stop you from learning the truth.
Spread out! If it moves, kill it!
What is this place? Tomb?
heck are they on the other side? I saw three of them. Where's the other one?
She went that away. They're leaving.
Close to the trap of Krypto to stop us now. The data points, what did they contain?
CD02 data intact. Initiating playback.
Elizabeth Sobeck. You've heard the bad news, and it's all true. The Pharaoh Plague is devouring the biosphere. Life itself will cease to exist. But does that have to be the end? What if we could give life a future? What if we could build a kind of seed from which, on a dead planet, life could blossom anew? This is the aim, the hope, of Project Zero Dawn. To create a super intelligent, fully automated terraforming system and bring life back from lifelessness. What would such a system require? At its core, it would need a true AI, fully capable of making the trillions of decisions necessary to reconstitute the biosphere. An immortal guardian, devoted to the reflourishing of life. We call it Gaia. Mother Nature as an AI. But that's just the core of the system. She will need to be surrounded and empowered by a comprehensive suite of subordinate functions. Think of them as extensions of Gaia's mind, each dedicated to a specific purpose. Now, these aren't AIs, but make no mistake, each presents an engineering challenge more profound than anything the human species has ever before attempted. Hardware that preserves and then gestates the billions of seeds and embryos from which life will be reborn. The construction of underground facilities to hold it all. And that's just the start. We don't have to build the entire system. The beauty of a fully automated terraforming system is that it can build itself. Now, over the days to come, you'll learn how all these functions, all these pieces that you'll be working on, fit together. How we'll race the clock to execute our harvest initiatives, write the software, build the tech and the facilities. How we'll lock it down and seal it up before the inevitable occurs. But even more important, you'll know how it doesn't end here. How Gaia will generate those deactivation codes General Harris talked about, and build the transmission arrays to broadcast them, shutting down the Pharaoh robots. Gaia will not just build, but imagine any conceivable robot it needs to do its work across centuries. From detoxifying the Earth's ravaged atmosphere and poisoned seas, to the regreening of the Earth from cryopreserved seed stocks, to rewilding the Earth with animal life. And then, when all that is done, how a new generation of human beings, spawned at cradle facilities around the globe, will partake of Apollo. The vast archive of human knowledge and cultural achievement from which they will learn of us, our world. And most important, how not to repeat our mistakes. It's not an impossible dream. It is within our grasp if we work tirelessly and stop at nothing to achieve it. We can't stop life from ending. But if you will help me, help Gaia, we can give it a future. Join me and help make that future real. Then, if it was part of Gaia, how did it end up in the wreckage of a pharaoh robot? And why does it want to kill me? And Apollo, the archive of knowledge, what happened to that?
I'm as confused as you are. Maybe the answers lie ahead.
If you're still nauseous. No, the inhibitors have kicked in. I can't feel the back of my tongue. I wish I could tell you I'd believe in this. But the damage is too great, too extensive, too complete.
Stuff I don't know about, but I don't know where the other ones are. Giving me health. I have to fight soon. I have a peeping.
Intruder! Get her!
Looks like we're introduced.
Whatever you do, don't die now.
Me.
Keep that for later. Need to find the right configuration.
Hey, I'm done with Brett's incompetence, okay? Somehow, he managed to install an H-emitter node backwards. Everything's in reverse. I don't get paid to clean up Brett's messes. If you want it fixed, send him up to storage for a new emitter, not me. Parker out.
Down, right, up, left. Down, right, up, left. Yeah. Is that right?
I should check the door nearby.
I thought she said it was backwards, but I guess this one's backwards because it's upside down.
Found one. Looks intact. That should do the trick. Now let's get that door open.
It's the same thing. Oh shit. That's why. So we gotta go down. Left. Up, right, down. Up, right, down.
That did it. Door should have power.
Now to see what lies beyond it.
Eclipse. They're here.
Avoid contact.
Lines look good.
Gaia, it's up there. Second floor.
Can you reach it?
So much for avoiding contact.
Kill the leader. Oh, I didn't get it. Crazy me. Better aim, shall we?
Who's firing at me? Don't lose her.
Elevators non-operational.
You cannot hear that.
That's the last of them.
Alert. Major structural failure. Repeat.
Or not. Clear. For a moment, anyway.
Then get moving. You have to find Gaia.
Could have used that gun. Oopsie.
I'll find a use for you. Forget about traveling light.
tip you off, this is going to be the subordinate function that Gaia will use to make lots and lots of robots. Her personal forge. Except, it's not that simple. You probably noticed that only about a third of you are robotics engineers. The rest, experts in machine cognition, virtual heuristics, that stuff.
Hmm.
Well, that's because we aren't going to be the ones designing and building robots. The last thing we want is to burden Gaia with a bunch of outmoded 21st century designs. Waste of time. Our purpose is to empower Gaia to build the robots. And not just build, imagine, from scratch. Any robot she needs for any conceivable purpose, designed and fabricated at a snap of a finger. Hers. Her finger.
This place is crazy. Super easy to follow, unlike some of the other past areas.
I think this is it. Elizabeth Sobeck's office. But it's sealed off. There's got to be a way inside.
Keep looking.
More Eclipse.
Careful now.
How about the fact we exist at all?
To abide in ignorance is a curse, Aloy. You of all people should know that.
Welcome to Apollo. The collective memory of the human species and the wellspring of knowledge for future generations. I am Samina Ebaji. Until recently, I was director of the International Collective Memory Institute in New Tehran. As a heritage professional, I devoted my career to the preservation of human knowledge, creative endeavor, and cultural achievement. Apollo is, therefore, ultimate embodiment of a lifelong passion, albeit under the very worst circumstances imaginable. The challenges before us are immense. Specifically, we will have to design and implement 4 major initiatives simultaneously. First, the construction of data repositories in cradle facilities around the world, ensuring we... Second, the collection and processing of a projected work.
Not too hard, but mostly annoying having to like scrimmage through all this crap. Is it 1 o'clock? I've got to not take too long. Mission is so back. Where do I go? Oh my
God. Welcome to Hades. Zero Dawn's Extinction Failsafe Protocol. The ultimate killer app. Now, I know what you're thinking. The purpose of Gaia is to resurrect life. So why give her a subordinate function, only purpose of which is to wipe out life all over again? I mean, what the... what? Just plumb crazy, ain't it? Well, no, it isn't. Reconstituting a biosphere? That's a tall order. Tech smart as Gaia may be, odds are she won't get it right the first time. I mean, imagine your guy 200 years from now and this new biosphere growing, it's all gone wrong. Alkalines are skyrocketing, coniferous forests eroding under the lash of superstorms that would have drowned Noah. It's chaos, spinning top that won't stop wobbling. Now what are you gonna do? Release phase one organisms into that hot mess? Hope they're CO2. Step aside while Hades takes over and does what you're just too darn nurturing and life-loving to do, which is burn that misbegotten mess of a biosphere to the ground so Gaia can start over. Okay, not burn, more like reverse terraforming operations and suffocating. But you get the idea. Hades takes the biosphere back to zero. Square one, blank slate. And then, only then, does it hand the steering wheel back to Gaia and say, try again, old girl. And better this time, or we'll have to do this again. That's Hades. It's pretty badass when you think about it. Extinction on demand. Death on speed dial. All for the greater good, of course, but still, kind of metal. So welcome to Hades. Welcome to the void.
Okay, so if that's the original, looks like the only way onwards.
What happened? Cut me off.
Welcome to Eleuthia, the crown and king of Gaia's subordinate functions. For it is by Eleuthia that the human race will continue to exist. I am Patrick Brochard-Klein, the Alpha in charge of this program. Now let one thing be perfectly clear from the outset. Eleuthia is not a genetic engineering project. Our goal is to preserve the human genome, not alter it. A snapshot of human genetic diversity, literally frozen in time. The genetic quintessence of our species, unmodified. Under my watch, our activities and initiatives will comply with the 2034 global provisions and the 2048 rally accords. Now that may seem a quaint, even trivial concern to you in light of present circumstances, but as one of the authors of the Accords, it is far from trivial to me.
Cradle facilities. Elizabeth said a new generation of humans would be spawned inside such places.
She did.
All Mother Mother. It was one of them?
There's only one way to be sure.
The hatch wouldn't open. Something about a corrupted Alpha registry. I need to search Elizabeth's office.
Though Capric forms show superior load-bearing capability.
You're a quick study, Gaia.
Dr. Sobek, as I have conducted this comparative analysis of mammalian morphologies, I've gathered extensive data.
You will undergo a brief period of unconsciousness during relocation to Prime and final instatement.
Elizabeth, may I speak outside protocol?
When you're back up and running at the new site, we'll bring the subordinate functions online and see where we stand.
Elizabeth, I detect distress. Are you all right?
I'm fine.
I realize that circumstances compel us to launch earlier than we hoped, but all subsystems are operational. The odds stand in our favor.
But what if... Gaia, there's nothing left out there. You can't even survive unless you're wearing an environmental suit. There are billions dead in fear and agony. What if it was all for nothing?
Elizabeth, extinction was inevitable. Thanks to you, life will have a future. Us would benefit from antilopany morphologies, though caprid forms show superior load-bearing capability.
You're a quick study, Gaia.
Dr. Sobek, as I have conducted this comparative analysis of mammalian morphologies, I've gathered extensive data on the quaternary extinction event.
Oh? And your assessment? Gaia?
Logically speaking, the extinction was a natural consequence.
And yet...
I find the loss of megafaunal species unaccountably sad. That they passed forever into oblivion causes me to experience a grief that is difficult to describe. Am I malfunctioning?
No, Gaia, you're not. This is good. It's very good.
Just finish up the data, because I didn't know those little
brief
things.
Period of unconsciousness during relocation to Prime and final instatement.
Elizabeth, may I speak outside protocol?
When you're back up and running at the new site, we'll bring the subordinate functions online and see where we stand.
Elizabeth, I detect distress. Are you all right?
I'm fine.
I realize that circumstances compel us to launch earlier than we hoped, but all subsystems are operational. The odds stand in our favor.
But what if... Gaia, there's nothing left out there. You can't even survive unless you're wearing an environmental suit. There are billions dead in fear and agony. What if it was all for nothing?
Elizabeth, extinction was inevitable. Thanks to you, life will have a future.
You really believe that?
I believe in you, Elizabeth. In you, all things.
Alpha Registry master file.
Intact?
Yeah. No signs of corruption.
Then what are you waiting for? Copy the file.
With this, I can restore the registry at the hatch inside All-Mother. Open it. Go inside.
And the
so naive. There will be no who waiting for you there, Aloy. Whatever birthed you into the world was a what, not a who.
You bastard.
Oh no, I had a legitimate birth. It's you, Aloy, who are the creation of a machine. But what kind of machine and why? Why were you created?
Shit. Eclipse.
You need to get out of there. What you found is too valuable. You're too valuable.
Oh shit.
Suitable death in mind for you, child.
Mm-hmm. Oh, he took all my shit?
My entire life, I've always known one thing with prophetic certainty. That I was destined for glory as a great champion of the sun. Even when Geron was murdered, even when Meridian fell, I never doubted my destiny. Until you came along. When I heard that you had survived, a doubt took root in my mind. As sure as the sun rises and falls each day, those I am bade to kill die. And yet I fail. How? Why? With each dig site you attacked, each loyal soldier you killed, this pestering doubt grew. I kept thinking of the moment my knife pierced your throat. One twist, a simple tug of the blade, and you would have bled out. In slaughter, I am a practiced hand. So why hesitate? Why fail my destined purpose?
If you're gonna go on babbling like this all night, could you just kill me now?
Oh no. We're in no hurry, you and I. Not now.
Maybe some physical torture to distract me from your voice?
At that moment, on the mountain, I aimed to kill you with dispatch, and yet did not. Why? This failing troubled my thoughts. Haunted every step. It was only when I captured you, down in that place, that I finally glimpsed the sun's design etched at length across the course of events. You were meant to survive that day on the mountain. Meant to interfere at dig sites and kill my men. Conversely, I was meant to capture you. Here, so that you might die as a sacrificial offering to the sun. Everything as it was meant to be. Predestined and preordained.
You're an idiot. A dangerous idiot, but an idiot. All this talk of destiny and fate. I'm sure Hades speaks the same language, doesn't he? You're being played for a fool. Hades is an ancient machine, not the buried shadow of Karja myth. It doesn't care about Meridian. It wants to kill everything and everyone. And you are its dutiful slave.
I serve not the buried shadow. But the sun in shadow. All halves of nature joined to one cause. Shadow to sun, dark to light.
Do you really not hear how ridiculous that sounds? You've gone from serving an insane homicidal Sun King to an insane homicidal machine. You're moving down in the world, not up.
I'll remember those words as I watch your corpse burn. Whatever's left of it. You fail to grasp the point. As surely as you've been conquered, so has all doubt. And with certainty of belief comes unstoppable force.
Then come to cage and put your faith to the test. See if things work out like you expect.
The circle has closed. Every element is in its proper place, exactly where it belongs. The errant beast, now caged, will serve her true purpose. A sacrificial animal. Oh, speaking of sacrifice, I forgot to tell you. After you crashed the Eclipse Network, I sent messengers into the east to rally the forces there and mount an invasion of the sacred land. I ordered every Nora killed. I was hoping to catch you there, but alas, it all seems to have been unnecessary.
Why butcher dozens of innocents for no gain? It's a waste of effort.
You're right. I won't even be there to enjoy it. In any case, I couldn't recall the order even if I wished to. Thanks to your destruction of the network, communication over distances is impossible. You not only doomed yourself, but an entire tribe. Do we not see the scorching judgment of the sun in these events? Your focus. Such a powerful device, isn't it? And yet, so fragile. So you see, this time, I did not hesitate. The knife has already been twisted.
Karja faithful, rejoice! Our years in shadow are over. A new dawn trembles on the horizon. A new day, soon to break. And when it does, the false Sun King will be dead. And Holy Meridian, ours once more. In this, I have become an instrument of prophecy. All halves of nature join to one cause. Shadow to sun, light to dark, night to day. Behold! Your seats! Can you not see the proof of the sun's blessing before your eyes? How else could shadows such as these prowl in broad light of day? Were they not approved by the sun and joined to our cause? Many years ago, to consecrate this great ring, the Radiant Juron ordered many faithless crushed beneath the hooves of the behemoth. Mighty is the radiance in the eye of the sun, but it is mightier still, infused with the power of shadow. Let this one, who schemed and slithered, be the first to die! Let her be the first of thousands!
Ah! never beat that thing without weapons. My weapons are up on the platform. There's no way out of this ring. Maybe I could use the strength against it. That pillar's weak. Another hit, and that pillar will come down.
Kill her! Kill her!
Why leave it to them? Come get me yourself!
So crazy.
Traitor!
So sick. That's cool. He's a real person.
So you're here. Really here. You risked your life.
Of course I did. If you'd been killed, the Nora Sacred Mountain would never have given up its secrets.
Too bad you wasted your time, then. Helis destroyed my focus. And the Alpha Registry with it.
Not at all. The whole time I've been monitoring your focus, I've duplicated every data file you scanned. Installing that data to a new focus was trivially easy. Happy birthday, Isaac. Daddy sure does love his little big man.
You're really good at making it impossible to like you, Silence. But I guess I need this.
It's time to see where you were born. Maybe you'll even learn why.
Yeah. Meet the machine that birthed me into this world. Isn't that how you put it?
I'll be off.
Wait.
Yes?
How did you track my location when I wasn't wearing a focus?
Really, Aloy. It doesn't take a genius to surmise that Helis would throw you into the sun ring at high noon. I wore out two striders getting here in time, but I did. Now be on your way.
Since when can you override machines?
Ever since you discovered the technique. I had to destroy a corruptor to obtain the necessary parts, of course. But your example showed me how to do that as well. Yet another benefit of monitoring your activities through the focus. Truth be told, the underlying logic of the technique isn't so different from rites practiced by Banuk shamans. Though, of course, far more advanced.
Great. You're welcome, I guess. Helis recognized you back in the Sun Ring. You told me that you'd assisted the Eclipse. Not that you knew the man who killed my... who almost killed me.
So now you know. The man is a serious threat. So let's do all we can to make sure that he and Hades don't succeed.
Right. I'll be on my way. To make matters worse, Helis ordered an Eclipse detachment to attack the Nora Sacred Land. The tribe's already weak. They won't stand a chance. You should come with me.
Oh, absolutely not. I have preparations to make elsewhere.
What kind of... Why do I bother asking? You're not gonna tell me.
When the time is right, I'll be in touch. I'll contact you later. In the meantime, should you need to return to Shadow Karja territory, I brought armor to conceal your identity.
You think of everything, don't you?
One of us has to. Aloy, when you were recovering the Alpha Registry down in the Zero Dawn bunker, I was needlessly cruel. For your sake, I hope there is someone waiting there for you inside the mountain. Not a what, but a who. Yeah!
That's a cool outfit. so school's having.
Advantage. I can use my focus here.
Day 12. As we watch the booster arc up into the night sky, riding a pillar of flame, you took my hand, squeezed it, and said, "You have written the story of our family. Across the stars.
I just gotta tough the storm out.
Man, that was crazy. Alright, I think I'll end this video because it's kind of long. It was crazy though, cool.